I've decided that every year I'll go somewhere I've never been before. So beginning of this year, I took a trip to Uganda with Sophie, of course. This video is a journal of my trip to Uganda. Good morning! Welcome back to my channel, guys. Happy New Year. I'm vlogging from Entebbe, Uganda. So I'm here on vacation with Sophie. If you don't know her, you've not watched my vlogs. So I'm so tired. We came by the evening bus. We've just gotten here at around 11 and it's raining. It's not supposed to be raining, but it's raining. So we're just waiting to be ushered into our rooms. I go freshen up, look like a decent person, then I can come back and vlog. So this is what we've been offered as we wait for them to show us our rooms. Sophie, you wanna be seen?
No.
That's Sophie, you can only see her hands. Guys, so I'm going to show you our room, or rather our bus. We got a bus, can you believe it? We're living in a bus, myself and Sophie. So I'll show you guys around. The other place, I'll show you, they have rooms, but we decided to live in a bus. We didn't plan on this, but we decided to be adventurous. So come, I show you how our place looks. So this is the entryway. You see, it's so artsy. So come in, guys, and see. So first of all, everything in this place is so artistic. Like a lot of thought was put into this, which I love. So we have the mirror there, then we have the hanging, let's call it the closet. There. Oh, let me switch on the lights. No, there are no lights here. Okay. So, yeah, this is where we hang our clothes if we were staying here for longer, but we're only here for 2 nights. And then here is the washroom. The other rooms actually have a bathtub, but this one doesn't have. But the fact that it's a bus just makes everything special. And then this is our shower. So you see, like, the devil is in the details. There's a lot of details in this place. So much detail. I hope it will have proper lighting so that you can take photos in here. And then this is our bedroom. We took one room. Look at how good it looks. This is our bedroom. Then the chairs, the bed, the towels. Voila, this is where we'll be spending 2 nights before we head on to Kampala. So guys, these are the standard rooms. I just decided to come film for you guys, just in case you are wondering how the other rooms look like, because you're staying in a bus, but the other rooms look like this. Yeah, I'm showering here. I just decided to come showering the tub because our room doesn't have a tub. So guys, I'm done showering. I feel so much better. We've slept, showered, now I can go eat and look like a human being. But let's talk about one thing. This weather, like, I didn't sign up for this. What is this? Why is it like drizzling the whole time? I did not sign up for this. Uganda, please behave. I need to wear bikinis. So we're going to have our first meal of the day. It's around 3 here. I'm so hungry. I couldn't even do my makeup. I could care less. I just want to eat. This one has been complaining because she's so hungry. Sophie, say hi. Say hi. You're so silly. So I just want to show you guys around this place. So this is the bus we are living in. That it has an extension. I think that's the washroom part of it. It's so dope. And then this is the garden. I think when it's sunny here, it's really, really dope. Like, you can really enjoy this place when it's sunny. Yeah, let me take you guys around. I like these details up here, the lanterns. And this detail here, this wall. Sophie, this is the wall I want to take a photo on. This one. Yeah, it's so pretty. Then there's this place. God, it should be sunny. I just want it to be sunny. Oh, good. And then that's it. And then the place is actually called Lake Victoria Country Room. Yeah, in Entebbe. So that's the gate there. And that is how it looks. Yeah. That's the entrance. I think this used to be someone's house and they converted it into an Airbnb. So if you decide to live here in the main house, you will have your own rooms, but share the main amenities. Does that make sense? Like the dining table and all that. Then there's this place where we can go and chill. Let me show. Actually, I hadn't come upstairs. Sophie came when I was showering. So, yeah. You can actually decide to have your meals here. Yeah. This is so dope. Again, the weather just has to be right. Like, this is so pretty. So pretty. I like the details in this place. Like, the interior decor is just out of this world. Yeah. So this is the entryway. This is dope. This is a really beautiful place. Considering the price, it's really, really pretty. And this is the entryway, this is the dining, and this is the spot I like to miss here. This. So we are leaving to go check out the ferry, because tomorrow we want to go to a place called Sese Island, and I hear there's only one ferry that goes there. We need to get the details, like what time it leaves and all that, if it will be comfortable for us and if we'll make it. Like, if it's too early, I don't think we'll be able to go. Yeah, so, and I hope the weather there is better than here. So Susan, who's the lady taking care of us, is taking us there. This place is actually a few meters away from the lake. It actually has, like, if you go outside, you can see the lake from here. So yeah. So this is the waterfront. So guys, I'm not sure about this Sese Island trip because the ferry only leaves here once a day at 2 p.m. and we wanted to make a day trip there so that we come back early because our accommodation is here in Entebbe. So I'm not sure if we'll make it. So we are back from Alex. Our walk. Susan, say hi. Susan?
Yes, yes.
You've not said hi to people.
Oh.
To my friend.
Where are they? I stand here.
Yeah, stand there. This is Susan. She's been taking good care of us. Yeah. Anything you want to say, Susan?
Hi.
Thank you.
The next day.
Good morning, this is day two of Entebbe. We've just woken up. Sophie is showering. I need to go shower. This place is still cold. I think we'll have to work with this weather. It's still gloomy. I really don't like it, but I guess we have to work with this weather. Yesterday, we came back. Had dinner. I couldn't vlog at that time. I think I was too tired. Then we slept early because of the journey from Nairobi. I think we were too tired. Yeah, but today I hope we'll be able to do more activities. We want to go see the Victoria Mall. I hear it's really big, and also go to the beach today. Regardless of the weather, we'll have to go to the beach. So yeah. This is our breakfast. Sophie, you have to appear on this video now.
Wait, you know the song? Three Chinese men were allowed to enter Kenya and went to Nyeri, and they have coronavirus. So the hell?
Why did they go to Nyeri?
I don't know. Nyeri women.
Oh, God. So we are en route Entebbe. We took an Uber, and we were just saying how in Uganda, let's say, Like, it's not so common. Uber is not so common compared to Kenya. Like, not so many people use Uber here, which is weird and awkward. So we are at the mall. It's called Victoria Mall. Apparently it's the biggest in Uganda, in Entebbe. And we're here to change our money. We didn't change all our money, so we are going to the bank to change our money, then have some fun. And yeah, I'm with her.
Hi.
Okay, come pole kwa hii video.
Pole, what do you mean?
1 hour later.
Okay, lighting, okay. Oh, so guys, we are at Protea Resort by Marriott. So we've come to the beach. It's a bit windy, but the show goes on. We have to change into our bikinis and at least experience Lake Victoria. So this is where we are chilling up here first. We want to eat, then go to the beach. So the clip you've seen before is actually the how the hotel looks like. This is the beach area. Yeah. Guys, the sun is out. Can you believe it? The sun is out. And the bikinis are out too. Bona sasa. Eh? Sophie decided not to carry her bikini for God knows what reason. Yeah, so she decided not to carry her bikini and she does not want to appear. But I'm forcing her to take photos anyway. Just like us,
the best thing
in the world. I never trade it for anybody else. So we are back home, changed into Dera's. I'm just having a good time now.
Ah, the lake is so close.
Right? You've seen it?
Yeah.
It's there. The lake is so close. Actually, we have a view of the lake right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, we want to read, get in touch with friends. Oh my God, where did they leave it? Get it in the room. I left my book in the room. I'm going to get it. Yeah, so just chilling here. It's upstairs actually. We've had a good day. The beach was fun. There was music. And let me tell you guys, always have hope. We went to the beach when it was raining and suddenly there was sunshine.
Drizzling, please do not exaggerate.
It was raining. It was raining and it was so cold. Ebu explained
yeah,
to them.
It was really cold and you were freezing and shining.
Yeah, we were freezing and shining.
No, literally, I went there with what are they called? The sport shoes.
Sport shoes, yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
That the rain
the sun
stop
won't,
the
yeah,
sun
the sun would come out.
Come
yeah.
Come it was nice. Anyway, yeah. The sun came out.
We had fun. We took
music.
Nice photos, music.
Yeah.
We watched people. Yeah, it was a good day.
I ate fish.
Oh. Yeah, and we ate fish. Guy, you guys, if you go there, don't fail to go eat fish. The fish is cheap. It's big. We ate one plate, two people, and we're still full till now.
Very cool, yeah. It's very affordable.
Mm-hmm. Ah, yeah. So, yeah. That is the lake. Can you guys see it? That's a lake from here. That's the view we have. Mm-hmm. Dreaming of this fantasy that there really is a
Day 3.
Good morning, day 3. Still in Entebbe, we're going to Kampala today. And it's my birthday. Yay! My birthday, by the way. So, I know what I'm going to do today, but of course it's gonna be fun. And Sophie is ignoring me because she's reading a book. I wish I never gave her.
Oh my God, this is so far away. I can't see my face there. Why are you?
This is the book I gave her and she's been reading it all through, like all through, even in the beach she was reading it. Today I think I'll choose to sit outside and actually eat from here. Thank God the weather is good. It's a beautiful morning. This one and her book again. But imagine I don't blame her. This book is worth reading. Like everyone should read this book. It is a good read. Our breakfast is here and I'm dying, like literally dying. I'm those people who, if I feel hungry, I start shivering and I can't do anything. I can't even walk.
Oh, you should have given it to me, I think.
The food is a lot. These people eat a lot during breakfast. It's not like us who just take tea and bread. Actually, we've not taken bread.
We've never taken
bread since we came here. Okay, so we are dressed up. We are waiting for the cab guy to come so that we can go to Kampala. I'm taking a few photos of Sophie and she's not impressed at all. I have bad photography skills and she takes good photos of me. Anyway, I'll just go for another round and try to take a better photo. I hope I'm lucky. So we are finally leaving. I'm on video. And I want you guys to meet Annette and Susan. They have been really helpful around here.
How are you?
That's Susan.
Is
that's
a man?
Annette. It's for my YouTube video. Not a man. It's not for a man. Yeah, so we are leaving right now. Uber guy is already here. So we've made a short stop at Munyonyo Commonwealth Resort. We just want to walk around before we check in at our hotel at Mbuya in Kampala. It's such a beautiful place. I think that's the route, yeah.
One hour later.
brightens up my day.
Our food is here.
So you're eating that alone? We won't finish this.
We want. I'll show you.
20 minutes later.
So guys, we are from the Gaba market. It's Gaba, right? It's Gaba Beach. Yeah, we've eaten and we have Steven here. Steve.
Hello,
yes.
Hello guys.
He's been taking, funny story, yesterday we ordered Uber to the mall and he's the one who came to pick us. So after that, we took his number and he'll be the one to take us to Kampala, and he's really nice. He's been very patient with us, took us to that resort that we went to, and now brought us here to eat at least good food, good affordable food before we head to the hotel in Buya, still in Kampala. This place actually has so many clubs.